This model is going to be looking at the different blood vessels throughout the entire human body. Now, this is going to be a flat board representation, which means that you're not getting a full three-dimensional view of the entire model. So you're looking at a flat board representation of this three-dimensional model. So if we go back up to the top, back up to the head, we'll start up in this region. Now, at this point, you're looking at the actual vessels up in the neck and head. So in the actual neck here, and just above the heart, looking at the aortic arch. Aortic arch has three branches that come off. You have the brachiocephalic trunk, which is back here, going to the right subclavian. You have the right common carotid coming up. Then you have the next branch, the left common carotid. Then you have the last branch of the left subclavian artery. As far as we're seeing for venous, this is the superior vena cava. The right and left brachiocephalic veins are here. And then we have jugulars heading up, which this model doesn't really show very well, so I'm gonna leave that alone. But looking as you come into the arm here, this is the left subclavian artery coming down into the left axillary artery and then into the left brachial artery. On the right side here, you have the right subclavian artery to the right axillary artery to the right brachial artery. Now beyond that, on the venous side here, I mentioned this is the right brachiocephalic branch here, the vein, which goes to the right subclavian vein, right axillary vein. So we have to work on repositioning the camera so we can see more of the arm as we go down. Now that we have this positioning a little bit more conducive for arms, you'll notice that in the venous system, there are three different veins here. We're going to have the right axillary vein here, but then notice it's cut off right here. That would go into the right brachial vein as it goes down. Now, what we do have though going here is we have the right cephalic vein coming down the outside. This is the right cephalic vein. Then the inside here, this one coming down right here, that's going to be your right basilic vein. So right basilic vein, which means we have the right cephalic vein here. This would be, if it wasn't cut off, the right brachial vein, and then the right basilic vein coming down. Once you get down into the forearm, then you still have the cephalic and basilic veins. This cephalic runs all the way down and keeps going. This basilic runs all the way down and keeps going. But then we also have in here, we see the branching coming down. Below that branching point, below that kind of mix you have there, you get into a deeper vein, which is going to be the right radial vein. And you can see it's a little cut right there, it's missing. But this would be the right ulnar vein coming this side. So that's looking at for veins going down into the arm. As far as arteries, we already discussed the coming in from here, this is the right axillary artery, right brachial artery. You can see the left brachial artery also. You then get down into the right radial artery and the right ulnar artery. Now on this side, because the forearm, you see the bones are crossed over, they switch over, so you gotta be careful on this one. So you have on the inside to start with is the right ulnar, and this is, sorry, the left ulnar, and this is the left radial. But then as the hand crosses over, they will flip-flop and come around with the forearm due to the fact it's being the pronation and supination. So the arm itself, the thumb being in, means that arm is in pronation, which turns them around. In the torso region that we're looking at here, you can notice that right in the middle here is the abdominal aorta. That's the inferior vena cava, the two big vessels. From the abdominal aorta, you have your cephalic trunk right here, going to the one side right here, so that's the hepatic artery. This is the splenic artery, with a gastric artery coming up and hooking. Going down a little further, you'll see the superior mesenteric artery be here, and then the inferior mesenteric artery is right there. You can have the right renal artery, left renal artery. These ones here and here are going to be the gonadal arteries branching off. For the venous side of things, we're going to have coming down here, you'll notice this is the hepatic portal vein. We're going to have the splenic vein coming all the way across. We have the superior mesenteric vein, the inferior mesenteric vein, right and left renal veins. Now from there, we're going to head down. It's going to start to branch here. But I'm going to work on trying to readjust the view a little bit to change it and get a little better view. All right, now that we have a little better view here, you can see when you have the abdominal aorta coming down, it splits into two, the right and left common iliac arteries. So if we follow the right common iliac artery, it'll split into the right external iliac artery and the right internal iliac artery. Same for the left side. The left common iliac artery splits into the left external iliac artery and the left internal iliac artery. You can follow that down into the leg. This is the femoral. This happens to the left femoral artery. And just to show again in the forearms a little bit, it's a little easier view now. You can see this is the right radial artery, left, sorry, and then the right ulnar artery. So right radial artery, right ulnar artery. And then you have that loop is the palmar arch. So that loop is the palmar arch. As you continue down through the rest of the left femoral artery, that left femoral artery will go down to the left popliteal artery here. Left popliteal artery that heads on down in the lower leg, which you have to readjust to be able to see that again. Now that we've readjusted, you can see the popliteal artery a little bit easier, which probably wasn't seen last view. From the popliteal artery, we can stay posterior, so the posterior tibial. And so this one's going forward, that would be the anterior tibial going forward. So posterior and anterior tibial. What we'll notice is this long one right here, which was all up top, but comes all the way down, keeps on going down, is the great saphenous vein. So the great saphenous vein. So some blood vessels of the flat man.